What you are actually seeking is harmony and equal dignity. But the route you are taking is causing further division. How does this work? Is there such a thing as right hate? There is no right hate. You may, of course, justify it as righteous hate and the consequent righteous violence. You feel righteous in hating because you were hurt once and are afraid you will be hurt again. And hence you turn your hate and fear into violence. But please pause and realize your hate burns you first. It burns your family and your future. Of course, it also takes down the person you hate. It takes down their family and their security too. With hate, the world will only become a vast crematorium, a burning cart. If you're listening to me today, pause and ask yourself, what is this violence for? Please ask yourself, is violence a way for you to punish those who have hurt you? Is violence a way for you to put fear into those who can hurt you in the future? Or is violence a way and an expression of your own repressed pain and fear? If your violence is a punishment, please know that punishing someone does not transform them. It only makes them hate you more and makes them bide their time before they can hurt you back. If it is to put fear into them, so they would never hurt you back, fear is only creating further division, further separation. What you are actually seeking is harmony and equal dignity. But the route you are taking is causing further division. How does this work? If it is merely an expression of repressed hurt, expressing anger or hate can only give you momentary relief. What it actually does is to train your brain and consciousness to further violence. Let us remember that there is only one way out of this predicament for everyone, whether you are a victim or an aggressor. A massive culture of self-awareness and compassion must sweep across the world to every nation, every organization, every family and the world. Otherwise, we are going to burn ourselves with violence and war. Incredible amounts of consciousness education and meditation must become part of the training of people in power and authority. Be it the police, be it the military, be it the judiciary or the executives of government or the politicians. You cannot waste power in the hands of someone who is not awakened to compassion. You cannot waste power to control whole masses in the hands of someone who has not yet silenced their inner demons. This needs work on an emergency basis. We need to become conscious of our bias, our prejudice, our reactions to anything that is different from us in color, in appearance, in our belief system. You cannot crush someone's throat because they have more pigment on their skin, while nature gave less of that blessings to you. We need to realize that we have absorbed prejudice like sponges. These prejudices have been flowing into us from generations and will continue to flow to the next generations too. This has to end now.